All right, you guys, let's talk about the anatomy of a long bone. So remember, long bones primarily act as leverage. So your humerus, your femur, the radius and ulna, the fibula, the tibia, those are long bones. So they're providing leverage for your body. The anatomy is pretty unique and it's worth learning. So when we look at a long bone, we have to remember those directional terms that we covered in our first module. Remember proximal and distal? Proximal means closer to the body, and distal means further away from the body. And when I say the body, I mean your torso. And so the ends of long bones are both referred to as epiphyses. That's plural, but epiphysis is singular. So the end of a long bone that's closer to your body is called the proximal epiphysis. And then the end of a long bone that's further away is called the distal epiphysis. And this is a picture of a humerus. And so that proximal epiphysis articulates, so connects to the scapula. That's the bone, your shoulder blade, that is part of that pectoral girdle. The distal epiphysis articulates with the ulna, which is a bone of your, and we're going to use a fancy anatomical term here, your antebrachium or your forearm. Okay? Now, between the two epiphyses is the diaphysis. The diaphysis is the shaft. So all long bones have a shaft, and that's the portion between the two ends. Now, some other interesting anatomy is that at the end of all of your long bones, you have this articular cartilage. That articular cartilage is composed of something called hyaline cartilage. Hyaline cartilage is a smooth, glassy type of cartilage, not a lot of thick fibers, but it has a smooth and glassy appearance, and it just provides a smooth surface so that these joints can move freely. When we talk about joints, we're going to talk about freely moving joints, synovial joints. Now, towards the neck of long bones, there's a region called the epiphyseal line. The epiphyseal line is this visible line that was the active growth plate. When we are young, when our skeletons are juvenile, they grow at that epiphyseal plate. So if it's called an epiphyseal plate, it's because that's an actively growing growth plate. Once we reach maturity, our skeletons solidify at those epiphyseal plates, and then it becomes an epiphyseal line. Some more interesting anatomy, this outer layer of connective tissue that surrounds all of bone is called periosteum. Peri means around, osteum sort of has that osteo prefix, suffix in it, bone. And then it's a smooth connective tissue that surrounds bone tissue. On the inside of bone, you have similar connective tissue that lines the inside of bone, and it's called endosteum. That prefix is endo, and endo means inner. We're going to hear a lot, peri, around, endo is inner. Another prefix, epi, means outer or above. So we're going to see that prefix a lot too. One more piece of anatomy, the medullary cavity. Because long bones are long, along that shaft, the diaphysis, there's actually a cavity in the center called the medullary cavity. In that medullary cavity is that yellow bone marrow. Yellow bone marrow is a high caloric fatty substance that is utilized for energy if you're in a state of starvation. Okay, so the typical long bone has this important anatomy. And when you are tackling the appendicular skeleton, you're going to learn about all of these long bones, the humerus, the femur, the fibula, the tibia. In fact, the bones of your mid hand and the bones of your mid foot. Those are the metacarpi and the metatarsi. Those are also long bones. Let's continue talking about bone tissue.